Hey, good afternoon, everybody. Mark again here, Weatherman Plus, with your afternoon update on what's going on in the tropics. And unfortunately, we've seen a northern turn towards Jamaica a little bit better. Now, if you remember, all week long, when I kept talking to you about this high pressure building over here on the southeast and a high pressure in the Atlantic, and it's going to leave a little bit of interaction chances to pull these waves further to the north. So that's what we're seeing latest on the GFS and also the Euro, also the Canadian. They all agreeing a little bit more of a northern tick towards Jamaica. So Jamaica, it looks like you are going to be getting some stronger impacts than what we've seen earlier. Right now is at 20 miles per hour sustained winds, 150 miles per hour wind still. But the latest update from National Hurricane Center shows 21 miles per hour wind, so it is speeding up a little bit more. In fact, we have even another update. Now you are in a hurricane warning. That means a storm is getting closer towards you. Plus, it is on a verge of being a historical Cat 5, everybody. Look at this. Now it's up to 155 miles per hour winds, still moving west at 21 miles per hour. This is right on the cusp of being a Cat 5, just 2 more miles per hour. Remember, the links are in the description to help save you time. If you've never been here before, make sure you subscribe. I am all year long with my weather forecasting. Always put timestamps in the description to help save you time. Now, you see, we still have tropical storm warnings out for the southern part of Hispaniola. Also over here, we have the hurricane watch out for Jamaica, and this is going to be a warning as well. So far, showing a Cat 2, potentially bringing 109 miles per hour winds, 132 miles per hour wind gusts with it. Now, you can see the tropical storm force wind field is going to be passing by Jamaica, potentially, and you can see where the southern part of Jamaica, where the hurricane force of Cat 1 winds will be. This down here is Cat 2 winds. Still showing some chances for it to go into the Gulf of Mexico. Still, I will show you there is a trend there as well. And I'm still showing the latest information on the ensembles. Like I've been showing you, that this might just weaken down and become nothing. Now remember, I did repost all these videos on my account, so the links are in the description to go to other platforms where I have channels as well, so you can follow me there. And there's other links down there in the description for you to see. Now this is Barbados, so you can see what was happening as Beryl went by. We don't have a video from Caicos where the landfall was hit, but I got some for Barbados, St. Vincent, from the Grenadines. Here is St. George's, Grenada. Now you can see the storm surge that came in for the fisheries complex for Barbados. So just like I was showing you last week when I was showing you this high pressure right here was going to space out and weaken out. This high pressure and this high pressure was going to leave a little area right here open. And that's what's pulling Beryl north. Then it gets right to the edge of Jamaica, showing that it will expand back out on that high pressure and pull it back to the west. Seeing this on all three, that high pressure will expand back out and pull it west, almost straight over Jamaica. Here's a Canadian high pressure expanding back out, pulling everything to the west. Still showing it will go all the way towards the Yucatan because of the high pressure, but this does move and it starts going on an angle where it goes a little bit towards that west northwest, just like we've been talking about here towards northern Mexico, southern Texas. And you can see as it goes across the Yucatan, still showing it being northern on the Yucatan Peninsula. The more northern it'll be, the more chance it has to do something in the Gulf. The more southern, the more chance it's going to go into the eastern Pacific. Now, hurricane analysis forecast system A and B. Pay attention, Jamaica. This is the same model that predicted the strength that was going to be for the Windward Islands, and it was correct. So as it goes by you towards Wednesday early morning, you could get some possible banding coming across the eastern island. Be careful for possible tornadoes. Also, as it gets closer, by the time you go through Wednesday afternoon, this has been 12 hours of these winds and rain. Show a little bit below you, but you're getting all that whipping going right against the island as it goes by, showing that your winds will be strongest on the eastern and the southern side of the island. But you can see how it's engulfing the whole island with at least tropical storm force winds, bring a lot of that moisture just bulldozing through. You can see the same thing on B. The only difference is B intensifies it a little bit more, brings stronger banding across eastern Jamaica. You can see the heavy precip a lot heavier than what A was. But look at the winds. A lot stronger winds hitting on Jamaica than what A is showing. A lot stronger winds. A little bit too close. And showing is going right for the Yucatan, intensifying, bringing strong winds with that as well. A nice little strong hurricane. Look at that. Still, as it goes by the Yucatan into the Bay of Campeche, and still shows it will continually start pushing to the west. Now, having said that, let's go through the ensemble track guidance potentially. You can see with the automatic tropical cyclone forecast, showing it will be 48 hours of intensity towards Jamaica, and it will be around 4 days of 84 hours of intensity towards the Yucatan Peninsula, and in 5 days, be that tropical storm potentially into the Bay of Campeche. Remember, as more southern it is, more it's going to go to the west. Still showing it'll start going that west-northwest. I think the Canadian is about right now, what we can see in the models. Still show it can start taking that northern pull right towards Louisiana. And that is what the Canadian and the Euro sees in the ensembles, I'll show you. But at the same time, it has to take that northern track for the Yucatan Peninsula to make that happen. Now, when you look through the Canadian for Beryl, you can see it's showing that it will make that abrupt turn on average right towards Louisiana, towards Texas. Still, matter of fact, look at Euro, almost exactly the same, even the zigzag going on. So we still need to keep our eye on it, even though it's looking like a western push. Something could be down the road that we could see, and it'd be a problem. GFS taking it right to the west. So this is why I gave you the hour's latest intensity guidance, showing in 48 hours for Jamaica, anywhere from still a Cat 4 major hurricane to a Cat 3 major hurricane. Now showing it would be maybe a high-end Cat 2 to a Cat 3 major hurricane. Please, Jamaica, take this seriously. It's starting to look worse and worse for you. As you go towards 84 hours for the Yucatan Peninsula, still showing you will have either a strong Cat 1 hurricane or stronger. But it is agreeing more likely would be a strong Cat 1, maybe a low-end Cat 2. Then as it crosses across the Yucatan Peninsula, the low pressure putting shear, the dry air, all the shear is getting. Look, still don't show anything after 5 days when it gets to the Bay of Campeche. Afterwards, we still don't know what's going to happen. I think it's going to take that westward push. That's what I'm really counting on. I'm not cheering for this at all. And the Euro is agreeing now on that northern track, like GFS has been seeing. Now remember, GFS is taking it weaker. But either way, both of them is showing it is going to be a serious flooding issue coming across for Jamaica. That's GFS. This is the Euro, and the Euro's just now catching on to what the GFS has been showing, that northern push. So that did show true. But unfortunately, that means also the winds has gone northern, just like the GFS was showing. Now remember, GFS does it take it a lot weaker of a system, and it brings you 50, 60 miles per hour wind gusts. Icon takes it further to the south, like it was showing earlier with the strong winds. But the Euro is taking it right on you now. It is agreement this could be a potentially a direct hit, bringing over 100, over 115 miles per hour wind gusts, maybe even 120 by Long Bay. Please be careful. Remember, these links are in the description for you. You can zoom in and see what the latest update is. When the next model run comes through, the new information will show for you. And the latest information on NVEST-96L shown in 48 hours has still have a chance to be a weak tropical storm, a strong tropical depression, bring more flooding towards the windward islands. Also showing by 84 hours, could be going towards Jamaica as a strong tropical depression or a strong tropical storm also. And maybe strengthen up after that towards the Yucatan again, just like Beryl. We also have updates on the MJL, our potential velocity anomaly, showing now from the 10th through the 12th, we need to check out for a wave that could make it through all this unfavorable environment and strengthen up and be a potential problem for us. Then showing maybe something will grow into the Eastern Pacific, maybe into the Gulf, more likely the Eastern Pacific from this. I'll keep you updated. But showing it's going to get active again as we go through July 25th, then very active again as we go through the beginning of August. Now, we do have severe weather, so I have this running for you in the background. Remember, timestamps on the top left corner is Central Time. That way you can change it accordingly to what you're looking at. This is the systems for tonight, also for tomorrow. Thank you so much for your time, everybody. Hope you have a great night tonight. I think we're going to see, just like we've been seeing in the GFS ensembles, all these waves are going to start weakening down to the west and start going away, bringing a lot of flooding, unfortunately, to Central America and Mexico. But I believe it is going to start going away. I don't think it's going to be all this northern turn hype. I know the ensemble averages show it for the Euro and the Canadian. I think we'll see that go away on the next resolution. Psalm 100. Make a joyful noise unto the Lord, all ye lands. Serve the Lord with gladness. Come before his presence with singing. Know ye that the Lord, he is God. It is he that hath made us, and not we ourselves, and not monkeys or apes neither. We are his people and the sheep of his pasture. Enter into his gates with thanksgiving, and into his courts with praise. Be thankful unto him, and bless his name. For the Lord is good, his mercy is everlasting, and his truth endureth to all generations. Amen. Have a great night, everybody. Jamaica, make sure you get your preparations on it. This is your last night to get ready for tomorrow. It's coming early into the morning. My heart goes out with every single one of you. God bless you all. Keep you all safe. Pray to Yahweh. He could save you. Make sure you pray. It's very important you let him know what's coming out of your heart. It's very important. Don't just let this chance go by. Repent and pray. All glory goes to God, our Father in heaven, Yahweh. And I always hope he keeps you safe every single day of your life. You, your families, your neighbors, your friends, your enemies, everyone around you. Because remember, it's not flesh and blood we're at war with. It's powers and principalities. It's not flesh and blood. We're all vulnerable. We all have issues. But we need to be there for each other. Forever. Amen. Hallelujah. Amen. Have a great night, everybody. God bless you and be with you, Jamaica. I pray for the best for you.